All right, a friend of mine asked me to make a video on my bug out bag and what I carry. This is still an evolution, it's still going on as better products come out and stuff like that and stuff that I can afford. First thing you want to consider is what you're going to wear. I always typically have a second and third clothes, you know, either for summer or for winter. Try to make them like cargo pants or something like that. Try to make the shoes comfortable. I always carry like a second set of work boots too, that are comfortable, that are going to hand up to a lot of wear, and that can handle, you know, walking. I always try to have a hat too. Keeps the sun out. It could be anything. You want to try to keep it subdued. You don't want to be your bright and flashy if you are actually using it for a bug out situation. I have the 511 Rush 72. It's rather expensive. I think it's $160 on Amazon. I actually got this at a garage sale for $20, so it's fantastic. Before that, I had the United States Marine Corps FILBE assault pack, 3-day assault pack, with the attachment on that one. And that one's pretty good. It's got a lot of good reviews. And all this stuff you can actually buy on Amazon or eBay. So, you know, look for it. You're going to have to want a hydration pack too. Now this one does have one on the interior you can put, but I find it's actually easier to have this in the back. And this is Source. This is what the Marine Corps uses for their water filtration, hydration bladder. I find Source to be very good too. You can get Platypus or Camelback, but you're going to pay more, and they're not as resilient or tough. And Source, and I got the 100 liter one. It's got the latest state of the art on this one. So if all you need is just the water bladder, then get that. But I got the entire package so I can carry it on my back separate too. You're going to want to try to carry all the useful stuff and most commonly used stuff and easily accessibles or in your side pouches too. So I'll go through the contents right here. Sunglasses, especially in the winter, you're going to want some form of sunglasses. Eye protection, and that goes along with the hat as well. Got a little flashlight right here. Runs on double A's. And you're going to want to try to keep all your electronics compatible with the same kind of battery sizes, AAA, AA, 1, 2, 3s. So I got the AAAs, AAAs. I've got a headlamp in here. Just, you know, your Walmart special. I do have a more expensive one that I plan to use. It's a Thrunite. It's like 780 lumens. And it runs off the 18650 batteries. So that one's really nice. I like this one. I might get the Fenix because this one's more of a thrower rather than a wider field. And I prefer walking a little wider, but we'll give it a whirl. The first couple nights I've used this has been really effective. And that one was $40, a Thrunite. It is a Thrunite TH10. I really like it. It's well built. And then I just got the Walmart special and then a compass, you know. Cheapy compass. You can get Brunton, makes really good compasses. And I got a little solar panel backup. And I have asthma, so I'm always going to keep my inhaler with me. Then I have a lighter. And then I have some backup CR123 batteries. And that's in the parts in the front. And this one, I have my Leatherman multi-tool. This is the Wave. It's fantastic. I use this one for work and I use it on a daily basis. It's worked out really well. I would like to get the Leatherman TTI, the titanium one. It's a little better quality. It's more expensive and it's a little bit better quality. And this one I also have in the back. I also have a sharpening stone. And then I have a fire steel on the side there too. This is a Fenix light. It's 960 lumens. It's adjustable. I have this one for work. This is fantastic. It uses the 18650 battery, the big ones right there. And I have the recharger for it. This is by far and away the best flashlight I've ever used. It's fantastic. Well built. Pouch holding up. I mean, I use this for work on a very frequent basis. Just some gloves. You're going to want some work gloves. You can be leather or anything like these. These are the Condor gloves that I have, or Voodoo gloves, I'm sorry. Voodoo Tactical. I think I paid $20 for these. These are pretty good. I always carry a Bible with me. I think it's essential for a bug out bag. You know, I'm a Christian and I believe that God will comfort those who need it. So I definitely carry a Bible with me. These are some USB plugs and adapters for my electronics. I have some headphones so I can listen to stuff. So this is just a camouflage bandana that I have there, and it's got multiple uses for that. I have some coined silver coins, the pre-64 silver coins that I carry. Sharpener right here too, and multifunction, and it's got a little button compass on it as well. I got some pens, pencils, little candy bar too. And that's another thing that I need to have more on is like comfort food or quick energy food. So you're going to want to have like a Snickers or Baby Ruth or maybe a Hoorah bars, something like that. Firesteel, Dave Canterbury sells these. These are fantastic on Wilderness Outfitters. Archery.com. I think that's all I have for the cookie. And the side. I have my water filter here. I got a Sawyer. I think these are $20. These are fantastic. Sawyer water filters. You can work them in line too, so I can hook this up to my water bag, my hydration pouch, and then work on. This is a Sawyer Mini. They're good for like a million gallons, and you can back flush them. So, from what I understand and the research that I've done, I've used this myself. I've had no problems with this. It's easy to use. The only problem is you can't let it get frozen overnight, otherwise it'll become ineffective. But Sawyer is fantastic for the value. Paracord. More paracord. For that one. By the way, this is the 550 paracord, the 7 strand. There are different strengths and qualities, so you definitely want to try to get the 7 strand ones if you can, the 550 paracord. Rechargeable flashlight. This one has two ways to do it. It's got solar power, and it has a wind-up crank. So then in the event, I can just wind it up at night and it'll flash. This one's made by Energizer. I think I got this one at Farm and Fleet, or you can get these at Walmart for a couple, you know, $10-$50. I got the Bahco Laplander folding saw. And this is by far and away the best quality folding saw I've ever used. It's got fantastic reviews, and everybody, it's an all-around great thing to carry, and it weighs almost nothing. So on this one, I have two different kind of blades as well. I got the Kbar short right there. I do have the Kbar long, but I don't have it in this bag, the original size, and that's a fantastic map. And then I have the Esee 4, so I really enjoy the Esee 4. I have the Esee 6 as well. It's a little bit too big to carry for me, so I keep that at a different location, different, you know, my house or something like that, and a car or something like that. But the SE6 and any SE products for that matter are fantastic. And the main pouch. Got some rechargeable batteries, AA and AAA. And then I also have a travel solar panel charger with the USB port, so I can charge my phone or whatnot. And then you just lie this out, or you can attach it to the back of your backpack while you're walking. And it's got right there the batteries that you can plug in. But this is my PowerFilm Solar. You can get the Goal Zero. I've heard pretty good things from Goal Zero as far as their quality for solar panels. I have a Smog that I bought, you know, for cover for my head or for just sitting on. If I want to sit down and I don't want to get my butt all wet or dirty, I can sit on that. I got a rechargeable flashlight crank and flashlight also. Radio. So in case I want to hear the news or just listen to what's going on, I can do that. Now, I would like to upgrade this one to a solar panel and crank short band radio, just for the added channels that I can get and stuff like that aren't limited to AM and FM. I have the first aid kit Hunter. I believe this is a Adventure Medical Kits, and they make their kits. Now this has a lot of additional stuff that I've got in this, but I find this, they have the solo, the personal, they have the groups, but they have different levels of this, and I'm really impressed with this. I carry a little extra ammo in there, little 22s, an extra battery for my phone, you know, some ointment and stuff like that. I have a backup cell phone. So, and a couple other like Israeli bandages and stuff like that. Food kit. It's your stainless steel GI that you can get in any Army Surplus store. This has shampoo, cooking oil, utensils, and then pepper and some seasoning, stuff like that. The only thing about this is it's really thin, so when you heat up the bottom, it cooks it super fast. So you're going to want to be very vigilant when you cook on an open fire or with camp stove as well. Some more headwear. This is just a knit hat, extra socks. This is Dryler Lint with a Bic Lighter fire starting. Fishing kit here. I got extra line, sinkers, fishing hooks, anything that you would generally use. I got a couple extra lures in there as well. 3-pack of paper to write on or for other uses, primarily for fire and whatnot, but you always want to keep something around if you want to keep notes or something like that. Bowie hat. For just walking around, I can just throw this on. Good to go. Fits pretty well. Does a good job. Deck of cards. Map of the state. Tissue. Kleenex. For obvious reasons. And this one, I carry a set of yo-yos. With magnifying glasses there. Or lenses, I should say, for... So you can start fires with that or magnify stuff with that. The yo-yos, you got to make and check and make sure that they're legal in your state. But these are the automatic fishing ones. You just tie them up, throw them on, hook them up, tie them to a branch, and when a fish bites, it'll reel them in for you. So you can do other areas. This is my Silver Fire Scout. It's a portable rocket stove. I'm not going to put it together because it's a pain in the butt, but you can do research on the Silver Fire Scout. They're fantastic products. This one is just like a general use like survival bag that I bought at Walmart for like $15. And it's got a solar blanket in there, you know, chem lights, green, you know, fluorescent tape, iodine pills. It's got a bobber in there, some fat wood, and I've just kept it. It's got a candle in there too. It's salt, pepper, bandages. So it's got a lot of general use items that most people carry. And I've carried it over, you know, during the evolution of upgrading my bug out bag, and it's so useful that I'm gonna keep it. Plus, the bag itself is waterproof, and that in itself could have multiple uses there. And this is just a little shower kit bag that I bought at Walmart. And it's got two different areas. And this one I got several items. I got handy wipes in here to clean. This is some stuff that helps with like rashes and itches and stuff like that. Some salve if you're walking in the woods in the summer and you get something here. Crazy glue. This is another wet towelettes here that I carried over from my old bag. Toothpaste, toothbrush, soap. This is Burt's Bees chapstick, and you can also put that on your blade. So the blade, if it's 1095 steel or if it rusts, you can put that on there to help prevent it if you're using it in a wood. Sewing kit right here, a little army sewing kit that I picked up. It's got scissors in there. Different needles and stuff like magnifying glass with the tweezers in case you need to get something out. Splinters and stuff. Moleskin. This stuff is fantastic and I've used this before. A lot less painful than using a liquid moleskin too. This is DEET 100% repellent, deep woods. This is a little case for some waterproof matches that I got. Pen. Black marker. And another bottle of the Burt's chapstick. On the other side, I got a blanket, solar blanket. Two of them. And then I just got some ab water soup mix, and this happens to be pea soup. Then I also got an assorted kind of the Mountain House dehydrated food, and I got a couple other those. This one is the backyard, the backpacker's pantry. I find these are okay, but I actually prefer the taste of the Mountain House. I think it's a little better quality. And then this one, this is an entire set. It's got clothes that I vacuum sealed. It's got pants, it's got a shirt, it's got socks and a pair of boxers. So everything I would need to change out if I got wet or something like that. And that is pretty much it for that. You don't want to make it too heavy. You don't want it to be like more than 30% of your body weight. I'm 150 pounds, so I think I got this one at 40 pounds, which is fine with me. I have a physical job that requires going up and down stairs a lot with heavy equipment, so walking around for 40 pounds is not bad for me to do this. I also want to consider a handgun or a 22 or a rifle or something like that. That's also what you want to consider, and you got to consider the weight and stuff like that. But, you know, that's in a bug-out situation. That's something I don't carry very often. Hopefully that helps. If you have any questions, just let me know. I'll try to answer them as best I can.